Hey, Slick, it's me!
What the fuck do you want? You got my money, punk?
Hey, you got some coconut water or something like that? I need some electrolytes. Damn, it's kind of warm, isn't it?
Man, you got a death wish or something. Am I supposed to kill you now?
Oh, no, bro. Not me.
Nah.
Oh, yeah!
But that's my boy.
Yeah, but that's my boy.
He has betrayed everyone he's ever known. He's got you involved with the federal government, and he's messed up several business ventures of mine. He has got to go. And you know what? I'd like to say that this isn't personal, but it is personal.
But the feds, man. The feds have told me to kill Trevor, and I obviously can't kill them both.
The feds. Steve Haynes, Dave Norton. I own shopping malls. I would not employ those two clowns in. And I make one phone call, their careers, they are over. So you're gonna A, listen to some 50 grand a year pension hunter, or B, a billionaire, who even the president lets finger his wife, or C, try and be really stupid and save those two idiot mentors of yours and have everybody in the goddamn state crawling up your ass. A, B, or C, time's ticking, pal. Beep, 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 and your answer is...
Man, you know what? Man, fuck you.
Genius answer, pal. Total genius, but time is running. You think about it. Me, I got a triathlon coming up, and I am in deep training. Bye-bye.
Man, fuck you.
Franklin?
Lester, dawg. Man, we need to talk. I got a problem I need your help with. Man, actually, fuck it. Man, we all got a problem you can help us with.
Calm down, all right? Come to my house.
All right, I'm coming.
What's the panic, bro?
What the fuck do you think? Man, imagine a fucking scenario that will fuck things up the worst.
Boy, my mind is just racing. But you know, I don't want to say something that's really exciting, and then you have to act all deflated and say, no, it's just that somebody got the same tattoo I got. So why don't you just go ahead and tell me?
Some motherfucker wants me to kill Michael. Some other motherfucker wants me to kill Trevor. I feel I can't kill both of them. Man, I'm fucked, man. I don't know what the fuck to do right now. Damn.
Well, I can see that. Who are the motherfuckers?
Steve Haynes, this angry motherfucker from the FIB.
Yeah.
Devin Weston, man, you know the,
That angry rich fucker from whatever hole he hibernates in.
Exactly.
All right. I say, kill Michael, then kill Trevor.
Man, are you for real?
You're fucked, you know, I don't know.
You know everything, dawg.
I know, okay, but I'm sorry, I guess this is it. You know, I'm doing my best, man. I don't know how you can deal with both of them.
I know, man.
Shit. We're fucked. Every single one of us is fucked. Unless... Okay, Steve Haynes is under a lot of heat because of the shootings at Court Center. And Devin Weston is A, known to be a major asshole, and B, known to be friendly with Don Percival, who runs Merriweather. I think, actually, Weston owns piece of Merriweather. Right, 11%. Pretty good for a pseudo-liberal owning a private army. So, they would both love to be involved in capturing the bullion that we just lifted. If I tell them both that you boys are at the foundry in Marietta Heights melting it down, then maybe, both of them will pay you a visit and bam, we turn it into a bust.
I ain't got no better ideas.
All right, I'm gonna get in touch with Michael and Trevor. You go to the foundry, get yourself set up.
I got you.
All right.
What's up, homie?
Man, things are kind of fucked up right now, dawg.
It's all good, nigga. Who better to have in a fucked up situation than a fucked up fool like me?
Man, that's what the fuck I wanted to hear. Hey, look, I'm coming to your crib to get your ass.
I'm here.
We heading to the foundry place.
I mean, gay guys keep in shape at police. Well, most of them do, but wives? I don't think so.
Excuse me, what kind of shape are you in?
That's not important.
Hey, look, hear me out, man. If it's too heavy for you, you can back out. No drama.
Hit me with it.
Man, we got a real problem, dawg. My boys, man. Well, we're trying to save
them. You actually doing something for your homies for a change? Hell yeah, I'm in. Who wanna clap your homies?
Who don't, nigga? These Chinese dudes, some FIB cats, the rich white asshole who scammed us on them cars.
Devin Weston? That punk bitch? Why didn't you say we was creeping on him?
We ain't creeping on him, nigga. At least I don't think he gonna be there. We gotta take all the heat he can throw at us before we worry about how we coming back on his side.
But you is coming back, right?
Oh, hell yeah, we creeping on that fool.
Oh, so you ain't the mercurial motherfucker you fronting as, huh?
Man, I'm just trying to make something out of myself, dawg. That don't change who my homies are, nigga. It don't change my family.
Shit, nigga, you getting me all emotional now. Nigga might have to stop me from sucking your dick, nigga.
Oh, please, nigga, fuck off.
Man, every fool in this town got somebody who want him clapped.
Look, man, Michael and Trevor, they should be inside. Can you stay out here and let us know when the bad dudes is coming?
I got it, man. I'll holler at you. I don't take kindly to touching.
Our showdown with a private army, and you're bringing a rifle?
Yeah, I'm bringing a rifle. It's a good gun. It'll get the job done.
Hey, man, what the fuck am I doing risking my ass trying to save y'all ass? We're just gonna kill each other.
Hey, you're not saving me. You're saving him.
Ah, you're saving this fat fuck.
Man, y'all gotta keep y'all fucking heads right and end this shit. If not, man, I'll put bullets in both of you motherfuckers. Hey, they here?
I know them when I see them, homie. They creep.
All right, good. Y'all hear that? Now, if we're doing this shit, man, it's either now or never.
Come on, Trevor.
Fuck it!
Where do you want me?
All right, man. You go over there.
All right, where you want me?
You hold your position right there.
Okay.
I'm gonna go over there.
Watch your sector.
Gee, oh my God, wait. If I didn't have to save your ass just once.
Save me? guys just wanted some company.
Gets turned again, huh?
Bite me. Ain't anybody getting turned again, and you know it.
Hey, man, the way I see it, we only just begun to clean this shit up. We got a lot of old friends I think need to be re-educated.
A lot of friends. I mean, things could get really messy.
Nah, we just gotta silence a few noisy people.
Well, hell yeah, let me see. There's,
Steve Haynes.
Dave Norton.
No, we need him alive.
Why?
So nobody fucks with us afterwards.
What about that triad, motherfucker? The one that think you two boys is dating? Shit, you know he bound to come back.
Yep, there's that.
Well, who's the guy who set up Lamar?
Stretch, you want to throw him in?
Shit, Trevor will throw anyone in just to satisfy his bloodlust.
Whoa! Hey, it's called a fucking loose end, all right? Now, if we're going to be men of peace and tranquility, we tie up loose ends.
Man, Stretch has been a liability.
But then we're going to have to take care of our old pals, Devin Weston and Steve Haynes.
Fuck, what a mess, man.
Well, let's get it cleaned up. How about you get Lester on the line?
is this? Stop calling this number.
Hey, it's me, dawg.
You're alive. I thought someone might have your phone.
Nah, but look, I got you on speakerphone.
Oh, did Mike make it?
Yeah, I'm here.
And the other one?
See you putting the ground, Wheels.
Uh-huh. You, just calling for a chat?
No, we got some work to do. Can you get us some whereabouts?
Oh, I'll do my best. Who?
Steve Haynes to start.
And Devin Weston's ass.
And, Wei Ching. W-E-I-C-H-E-N-G. Wei Chang! Wei Chang! And Franklin's pal, Stretch.
Huh. Stretch?
Yeah, man, look, his real name is Harold Joseph.
Okay, well, I can tell you that Agent Haynes is taping a show over on Del Perro Pier. Shooting permit came up immediately.
Check it! I wanted to ice that fucker since the moment I met him.
All right. I got a signal from Mr. Harold Joseph's phone over at the B.J. Smith Recreation Center.
No, I got him. Let's keep him clear of known associates.
All right, thanks, dawg.
You got it.
What you got for me?
Tao Ching's credit card just bought a Magnum at the beach club in Pacific Bluffs.
Okay, I'll go ask his ass about his punk-ass dad.
When I find Mr. Weston, I'll send the coordinates.
All right, good.
All right, we made our plans, let's stick to them. We take out our assigned targets. Any deviation will lead to confusion and probably failure. We got one shot at this, guys.
All right, let's do this shit. Hey, the old man's here. He's leaving the Beast Club. I'ma do it. But now.
Tasso!
That was him. Hey, I got out clean. You dudes ain't gonna have no more triads coming after.
We ain't gonna have anyone to sell super weapons to either, but hey-ho! Who's up?
We still gotta do Stretch and Agent Haynes.
How you doing? Ass licker!
Pal, Stretch? He ain't a problem no more, Frank.
Shit, he wasn't my pal. He was a dude who janked us, homie. Thanks. So who we got, man?
What happens next is plant Steve Haynes in the dirt.
Into Up and Atom today. Up and Atom. Food from when we were morally superior.
Moving on Haynes. Les, see if you can patch me into his radio mic. What a last reminder of what an annoying prick he is.
Los Santos. A city of saints. A city of sinners. And nothing in between but the FIB.
Cut! God, this is crap.
Who writes this bullshit anyway? Okay, all right. You got this framed right?
Yeah, you're looking great.
Is it chin? How's the chin?
Oh, sharp.
All right, the audio's clean?
Nice. Oh, well, say something.
Check.
Yeah, it's great.
Okay, fine. We're on. I'm ready. You ready?
Speed.
All right, let's do this, people. I'm a professional. Let's go. Hi, I'm Steve Haynes.
Thank you.
God! The guy, what's his name? He shot him!
Jesus fucking Christ.
Requesting backup for a 187 at Del Perro Pier. This is recorded as FIP 18. Proceed with pilot.
Lester, I dealt with Haynes. You got a location on Devin Weston yet?
Yeah, I do. The Merriweather team was dispatched to protect him at his house in the Tonga Hills. I say house, it's more of a...
Yeah, whatever. I'll go up there and get him.
Hey, unless you got news from the Foundry team, I don't want to be disturbed.
We got a combat situation! Guard DW!
Just put down half your outfit back in town.
Cover me! Get a job!
I'm getting kinda bored of killing you, your friends.
What do you mean all our operatives are dead?
Come out!
DW!
You dirtbag!
Wait, hear me out!
No more talking! Here we are, Slick, with a few minutes for some one-on-one time.
Hey, we good, T?
Never better, amigo.
Good.
Franklin?
I'll be here. Franklin.
Hey, what's up?
I assume you got him?
Ooh, safe and sound. Ain't that right, buddy?
Hey, my bad, homie. I picked C. Ain't that a bitch?
You know, Devin, the way I see it, and hey, I'm no intelligent businessman like you, but the way I see it, there's two great evils that bedevil American capitalism, the type that you practice. Number one is outsourcing. You paid a private company to do your dirty work for you, and then you underpaid that company because you thought you were big enough and bad enough that you didn't have to play by the rules. Oh, number two, offshoring your profits.
Offshore?
Oh, it's horrible. You wouldn't want to be sent offshore just to save a little money, would you, T?
No,
Franklin?
I wouldn't.
Oh, no, I ain't going nowhere.
No, see, but we know your opinions on the matter, Devin. Keep your problems the fuck out of America, huh?
In this instance, when he puts it like that, it makes sense.
Of course it does. Hey, Devin, goodbye, my old friend. Thanks for all the advice.
Bye-bye.
So now what?
Now we keep a low profile and get on with our lives.
As friends.
Well, do I have a choice?
No, not really.
All right, then. As flawed, awful, totally uncomfortable, and poorly matched friends. Absolutely.
Oh, that's perfect. Then we can get back to the kind of capitalism we practice.
Shit, I don't know how much more better that is than Devin's con.
Ooh, hypocrisy, Franklin. Civilization's greatest virtue.
Jesus, your therapist has a lot to answer for.
I know, I still hate myself. But hey, at least I know the words for it now.
Yeah, but I hate you, and I know the words for it. So does that mean I don't have to go to therapy?
Look, man, you two motherfuckers terrify me of that middle age. I'm good.
You're right to be afraid, Franklin.
Yeah.
Be very afraid, Franklin. Tell you one thing, T. I'm getting too old for this nonsense. Oh.